All right, I just want to talk this evening here, The Magic of Dance Vote. The title is so funny, The Magic of Dance Vote. Never in my life have I thought I would see it, and yet I have written it. So I'm the credibility that has really brought in such a conclusion to this what? I have to vote if it's magic or not. Yeah, so it is kind of funny, and it does drive one to go, what the heck? Oh my gosh. Today was ridiculous. I tried almost like, it was weird because so many times in the dancing that I've been doing here, because I've been dancing a little bit more every day, I've been trying, you know, longer time frames, and what do we call this? The gosh dang it, I fell really hard on the floor, and so I'm like, oh, this is ridiculous. I went into shock. I think I've gone into shock, and so I couldn't dance any longer after. So it's kind of been a droll drum day, and so the best I have to offer right now is The Magic of Dance Vote. I don't think I have anything video factor. I'll try to seek through, but there might be something, it might be not be anything. But my gosh, yeah, there's a new Halti teacher that I saw. I can't remember his name. Starts with a T though, Teshechenko or something, and he's in the in New York, I think so. So wow, my gosh, yeah. He must be bored. I think it's a boring thing to be a teacher, and still have the facilities. You know, he must be bored out of his skull, because to have facilities like that, I'm thinking, well, my gosh, shouldn't he still be doing it? You know, why isn't he still doing it? You know, I don't know. I guess it's the factor of, you know, it has to keep going, it has to be like, well, I'm sorry, you need to dance for 3 hours straight, you know, so you're out, you can't keep going because you have fatigue. Do you have fatigue? Maybe that's what it is, he has fatigue. But yeah, what a beautiful, beautiful body I can see even underneath his old jeans. So yeah, wow. It's almost like a trip to Pilates just to watch him for a moment. You know, just to watch him for a moment, walking. I didn't need to take the Pilates school. I did go to it. I took the Alexander technique. The Alexander technique is very similar to the Pilates. It's more direct body to the floor contact action before the spring machines. But yeah, incredible. Yeah, it's great. I went right away from it does increase your pirouettes and your placement in your torso. So it does increase there where you didn't have them before. Maybe you had two, maybe you had three, maybe then after you have the four or five, easier. And so that's all it really does for me anyway. I don't know. I don't want to use it as a I have to go back to it. I don't know. It's just, you know, a long time ago. So what was I thinking? Yeah, how long do we take it on? How long do we take this on our bodies, you know? I'm kind of feeling, gosh dang it, I'm feeling really tired. I'm feeling fatigued. And I'm like, is anybody else out there feeling fatigued? I feel, do I have hepatitis, you know? Maybe I have hepatitis. Maybe I have something terrible, because I have to sleep often, and I don't understand. I don't understand what happened. It's like some fairy waved a magic wand over the whole region of where I live. A massive fairy, and so then I am just woozed into a different place. So then I'm thinking, well, gosh dang, if I'm continually in the action speak of almost being drunk, but yet not from being an alcoholic or not from drinking, I don't know. You know, I'm not contacting a doctor saying, hey, I have vertigo constantly. I'm not contacting a doctor yelling vertigo. No. Why would I do that for? If anything, the planet itself is spinning itself out of orbit because of all of our problems that we've done here. The pollution and all of this build. Anything. It's nothing to do with going and visiting the doctor. at this point it is asymptomatical of what has gone on with all of the billions of people. So anyway, are we collecting the €1 VAT, the €1 fee? What do we call it here? Gosh dang it, they have a special word in France for a fee, payer something there. But yeah, €1 to just fly on an airplane international for the arts. Yeah, the artiste for all of us. Through our entire lives. I'm tired of the stupid starving artist quote. Starving artist quote is ridiculous. And I don't think he's done anything great. All we've done is we've looked at Van Gogh, and there he's done. He's made his swirls of straw bales. And yes, he got his wish. He got his wish, didn't he? Van Gogh got his wish. For 100 years after, we've been straw baling it in these terrible circles, again and again and again. So I'm not happy. I'm not happy with the starving artist being accoladed after, because I think it's been a drive through time. He's actually given a commitment hour to how our actual modernization proceeds. He's given the answer. He's given an actual answer. Follow him, he's starving artist, and we accolade him into being superiorly worth. So once something is such a huge value, we have all of these people that are praising it like it is their new nirvana, and they have turned him into an idol. And so we have this idol of this vintage painting of the peasants in the field action, you know, just given in the mind. And so you have the straw out there gathered, and all of these different types of mannerisms gathered. And yes, okay, fortune teller he is. They were gathered this way, or they were gathered that way. They were gathered by this machine. It turned them twixt them this way, or turned them twixt them another. And so he painted him this way, and he painted him that way, as the straw went. So why? Why are we using him as our future guidance counselor? I really, really, really am a proponent of stopping that. I want none of this. This starve them out to make them great in the death. I think that's a hideous. I think that's an absolute hideous. Yeah, fortune telling power, I don't know. I don't see why that's necessary. Who needs fortune telling power of a time frame? We're just gonna weave straw, grow wheat, become a wheat in society, essentially. That's what he was saying right then and there. We will only be growing the wheat. You know, you saw them, you see these fields, or an occasional sunflowers in a glass. You saw them, you know, that's his big, big message to everyone. You know, behind the absence fairies, his big message to everyone that's the future hold. And so the future hold took it as, okay. It's almost like commercialism, it's almost like corporations themselves used it as their leader. Used it as their guidance counselor. Where do we go next? Well, Van Gogh said that we are making straw bales that look like this, or we're making straw bales that look like this now. So we have every shape and size, don't we? We have every shape and size of straw bales that come from the original wheat. And so now we have rows and rows and rows of food called breakfast cereals. That are stemmed from the wheat. And so there it is, you know. I don't know. It's just become kind of a weirdo, huh? It's a weirdo thing. I just kind of want to take that power away. I want to take that power away because I think it's been a bad guidance counselor. So if we can take that power away, so we don't have a Van Gogh telling the future of how to run the place, let's just not do it. Let's not do that any longer. Let's pay the real artists that live now in this time equivalent and stop doing the disaster, the death event. Oh, you're so old, you're about to die, I'll pay you extra, you know, whatever. Whatever is going on. Yeah, I don't know, it's just a talk. What else? Yeah, I'm stunned. I just slammed down hard on the floor. Gosh dang it. Oh, I can't believe it, actually. I can't believe it that I did it, but I was just off, you know, just off in dreamland. And it's like that. I can't... what was I talking about? The magic fairy wand? And my, it's like a tsetse fly. It's like I have had the tsetse fly sickness. I swear to God, I think that's what it is. And then here's my older brother still shrieking at me. Do not tell ever that you have a sickness ever, you know. Oh, come rain shower down on you, you know, turn you into some kind of mutant and try to operate on you. And it's like, okay, all right, already. I think I have resist power. I think I can tell them no. You know, I don't think it's like a force. You know, you're forced to go to the hospital. I don't think you're forced to go to the doctor. I don't think you're forced to do any of these things. I think that's just the people you're in contact with may be pushy. So don't contact them any longer. Just don't contact them any longer because they have a disease. They have a disease that they cannot stop being pushy about going to the doctor. So, you know, so we have one country that says, well, we'll jump into the water because it's cold, and that cures us. And we have a group of people from another region of the world that say, no, we do not jump into that water ever. We will shiver and die. So yeah, I'm sorry, I don't go to doctors. I don't go to doctors. Even though I did quote there, I give them a million for their health and medical, because I presume somebody does need to go to the dentist or something, I don't know. Oh my gosh. I hate it when I'm just talking because there's everyone's substance hour. Give me substance. And maybe that's all it is, you know. And so, but now I'm back to the radio off in somewhere in Winnemucca, Nevada or something, you know. I'm just a radio show that you just really need to hear during the stagnation moments, the stagnants, the times where it's just the static. That's my voice, you know. So what am I, the overland radio that stretches through the agonies of, I can't hear humankind any longer. I can't hear them, humankind, you know. I can't hear the colony. There's still that moment of static on the radio. Yeah. What a disruption in a way that I would be there. What a disruption. You can turn me off. At any time, as you're going down there. Is it still 55? Is it still 65? Gosh dang it, it's ridiculous. It's ridiculous. What is the reminisce of America today for me? Simply that. A place where I can go into static. That's the only America where I prefer. That's a difficult find. It's become a very difficult find. Yeah. All right, doll. I don't know. Oh, I did get an email from a cousin. I don't know. What is it all about? What is that about and why? She hasn't contacted me for years and years and years and years. Last time I talked to her, I was drunk as a skunk off of Irish coffees. And I think I vomited in the street or something. So no, I don't really know her. So it's very odd email. But yet, okay, I'll take it. I'll take it. I mean, it's been maybe over 15 years, you know, so I'm wondering the why. I feel a little bit pressured. I feel a bit pressured being contacted by people like this. It's like, well, okay, all right, you are my cousin. And yes, you have a child, and that child had another, and so you're a grandmother now. Congratulations. I find it difficult to muster that romantic, what is it? I don't know, compassionate side of a family event. A family event has occurred. I don't care if it's a life, I don't care if it's a death. I just don't waltz with it. I'm just not waltzing with it. So it's odd. It's odd. Like the common, I would call it a common chat. A common voice. That they want to be in sync with me in some way and talk normal. Talk normal. It's like a sting from a bee that I don't understand why. So presumption exists. Somebody told her to call, somebody told her to write. Presumption exists. I'm like, oh yeah. Okay, yeah, that family. I know the raft. So I stay away. I stay away. The raft is so loud that it is beyond the static. They are practically the media itself. So, I know I'm getting off into some poetic place. You don't understand me. You don't understand me. That's all right. Just to understand. Oh my gosh, I saw the most beautiful attitude. The most beautiful attitude on a woman ever, I think so. And I'm shy to even know her name in full. Oh my goodness. Yao. And it's just a square. It's just a square attitude. It's nothing flunky, nothing. I got the kick up of the foot. Just a beautiful square attitude, you know. And it's not a dog leg. It's just beautiful square attitude. And so I'm like, wow. So I'm a little wild out actually by that. Just to see it. Because there's just so much garbage out there. There's so much garbage. You know, you think about pure ballet, that is just, you know, wow. We just don't see pure ballet form. We don't see the pure ballet of the actual square attitude looking beautiful. Just gorgeous. So yeah, I'm just a little flawed. I'm a little flawed. I'm a little jealous, actually. I used to have a squarer attitude. I used to have a squarer attitude. But I don't know, all this time pedestrian style turns you turns you out like this, you know, your legs go out a little further too far. It's very difficult to get them behind you again and then make them square. So yeah, I don't know. You lose that up and under of your turnout. So you have to work really hard to get it back. Oh my goodness. I know. So what is this? How many years have I been dawdling in the fact that I think I was a ballet dancer? I think I did the ballet. I don't know. Years. I don't know. I've been here. I think it was like really, I started back in the 2011 more so. I started hanging upside down in Corsica though. So that is strange. In Corsica, I started hanging upside down. And there was one person in the past who was an upside down hanger, and he did that for a reason, back to the flow, body flow. But my reason was simply the circus, and so it's very interesting that my build up was to be hanging upside down first. So why was that necessary? So I needed the precursor to hang upside down before I would ever look at the pointe shoes again. And wear them. So it's very odd. It's very odd. Yeah. Now I'm thinking, well, maybe I ate a magic mushroom and I'm just still stoned from the event. It's impossible. All of this is very, very possible. I never put a mushroom out ever that it could not stop. I mean, maybe I'm on a mushroom, a life mushroom. You know, I ate a mushroom there and I can't stop. And I know it sounds funny, but if you think of the woman in the red shoes, and she put them on, and she keeps making the PK turns around and around and around, and, you know, until there's a train. But in a way, it is that same odd momentum, but not as fast. So my mushroom is not quite as speedy as her little crack habit. It seems like she was on something there. But my God, it was awful. It was awful. It was just awful. Yeah. Oh, and that scene, we have the two men and they're just talking and they don't care a thing about her. And she's just doing this PK menage again and again and around and around and around. And I'm like, how's this going on? They don't even care about their ballerina. And they're nothing. They're just the names on the plate and that are going to end up that, yeah, they maybe wrote it or they're part of the composition. But the ballerina is the one that the audience carries in the name. The audience saw her, you know, they did not see them. So yeah, that was a weird, weird scene. It was a very weird scene, but it was the red shoes, a really old version of the red shoes. But yeah, it was not afraid of death either. She just leapt out and blasted herself to death with a train. And so, you know, gee whiz, now in this time, are we allowed to have that going on? That is quite a gruesome travel for a ballerina to have. And my goodness, she just had to, in a way, you know. Maybe it was just all right. It was all right. You know, time allowed it. Time allowed that to happen to her. But I think now, in the stories of everything has to be so nice and lovely, that what? I think I did see, I am going back to this open day epilogue of this, I've never really seen this Kush dancer too much. I only saw the two things now. Well, no, I've seen her do the Nutcracker a bit, and I've seen her do more now. But what a great name. Although I am missing the large Russian infumia from it. It's a little too short. So I worry her career. Maybe she needs it a little longer, you know, she had a longer career. What I'm thinking right now is that piece, it was a piece of like a willy, some type of a sylph that just goes on and on and on and on. I don't know, you want my critique? Well, I'll give you the critique. She was definitely in a choreography, too much. It was over-choreographed, over-long, half of that. Cut it in half, and then the audience is happy. It was a pas de deux that goes on too long. Maybe it was the starts and stops of all of the rehearsal experience, but I just think it was too long of an event. And the choreography was too intricately tricky. Nobody wants to see tricks on a sylph in a tutu. We just don't want to see it. We want to see pure dancing that is easy. We don't want to see all this difficulty. Because in the choreographer's mind, he is seeing only this one dancer at that moment, and he is performing the choreography with her, and that is a selfish person. He has to think, is he going to ever have another dancer dance it? Well, he has to make it for another dancer also. He has to make it for several other dancers, several other women. It cannot be only for this one woman. Very selfish choreography. So that's my critique is, you want to see that in Des Moines, Iowa. You want to see it at ABT. It's not going to be your Kush, is it? It's going to be somebody else. It's going to be somebody else. And they're not going to give you what you wanted. Because you made the choreography originally too tricky, too intricate. I'm not going to say the word too difficult, but it is extremely difficult. You made it too much. So, and in the too much, what do you do with the audience? Does the audience even care? The audience does not care the too much. The audience does not care the too much moment. They're just like, oh, another over-worried event, you know, that we have to persist in watching. Here you have grudged her and him, that both the dancers, just through the mud of toil and work and worship of the art, for no reason. Because the audience really just doesn't care. They just wanted to see easy. They wanted to see easy every single time. Easy. Easy. So you don't give them easy. You know, if she has one hard performance, one hard day, or her punches aren't working that day, or the partner is just feeling weak, it's a ruin. And so it's like easy is even gone with the first cast. So the second cast is, oh my goodness, the cast in another city, forget it. So they made it too difficult, all right? So I like to critique, obviously. I don't even know who it's written by or anything, but that's my take on the whole synopsis of it. Beautiful, it's almost like a beautiful choreography to use for training. For training. Do you understand? A choreography to use for training. For a school. You know what I mean? It has that, you know, do this for a school. You don't do it for the stage. The audience doesn't want, oh my gosh, what's happening next? I'm being thrown at another trick from a sylph, you know? It's just ridiculous. They're not supposed to be making that many tricks. It's just too many. So anyway. So I don't know. What am I, scandals? A scandal for the moment? Because you're all lulled into the beauty of her high legs, all lulled into the beauty of her high extension. Yeah, it's just like a school event. It should be a school work piece, you know, a piece for training. That's all. And even that's too much choreography. It's just too much choreography for the brain. I think there's a point where it becomes too much choreography for the brain. I've been in these long, ridiculous pas de deux before. I've been in one, you know, 6, 7 minutes long. It's ridiculous. It's ridiculous. I mean, we've got people halfway through already snoring. They're snoring, they're snoozing, they don't care. I mean, who is it for? It's almost like it's just this mean temper tantrum of the choreographer against the dancers. It's a mean temper tantrum moment. But look at what I can do to you. You know what I look at what I can do to you. I have this power. Who cares about the audience? You know, they're just like blink, 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 and I get a new recipe on the recipe show. Blink, blink, blink. Oh, I went to the ballet. Oh, who cares? I got a new recipe on the recipe show. So yeah, the power fight is there. And it's just this choreographer fighting with his ballerina, the choreographer fighting with his baleton, his male. You know, it's just like, what is it? Is it a forgotten career? Are you angry? You didn't get to do it, so you just want to fling them around. You know, is that the reason? Weren't accepted enough? You know, you started looking at the agonies of the choreographer and why. Why did the choreographer go to such extremes? And it starts to become his own analyst statement. His own analyst statement in the sky for all to watch. It's like, well, gee whiz, dude. Gee whiz. You know, I'm sorry for you. I'm sorry for you that you have issues. You know, it starts to feel like issues. You know, you have to take dancers to like technique, 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 extra. You know, be like, oh no, I only hire the four pirouettes, only women. You know, you have to get like this. What's wrong with you? Who are you? You're just a rampage self that overexists in want and getting. It's a spoiled choreographer. So when we have spoiled people that are running other human beings, good gosh. And all they are is just a bunch of desperate dancers that don't have work. Looking for a promo or something, looking for a promo so they don't have to do a panty ad. They're looking for some promotional event in their career. I don't know. It's a tough job. Tough work. And I don't know, what can I say? I just don't think it's fun. I don't think it's fun. I don't think dancing is fun because of the choreographers. A lot of choreographers have just ruined it. Just ruined it for the dancers. You can say even the choreographers from the past have ruined it because it's again another Dong Qiu, or again it's another Swan Lake, or again it's another. You can say they've ruined it, but you can also say the current choreographers have ruined it because they're so dedicated to being like the voice, like the. It doesn't matter if it was a good choreography or a bad one. They just get the sound out, you know, they get the sound out that, did you hear about my choreography? Good, bad, or ugly? You know, did you hear about it? If you heard about it, well then, my goodness, I'm famous. So they're using this tactic, you know, on the bodies of the dancers. So the dancers are completely like, well, my gosh, what a terrible. Is it like I'm saying, that one piece, it can be a beautiful for training, but it's absolutely painful after a while for the audience to watch. Because it's too much. So that's all I can say for it. Too much, what do they call it, of a sylph. All right, I guess I'll let it go. Yeah.